I bought the Mavic Mini Fly More Combo over 1 year ago. It has been one of the best under 250 grams photography drones I have flown. DJI has done a nice upgrade job, as the Mavic Mini 2 has everything I was hoping for in the original Mavic Mini. Starting with what I like best, in order of priorities, of the Mavic Mini 2, which prompted me to upgrade, 4K video at 30 fps. This put us on par as other popular 4K drones nowadays. It also supports 1080p at 60 fps for slow motion. The video is stunning, with better saturation than the Mavic Mini. The availability of OcuSync 2.0, which provides much better video transmission, and distance, 10 km versus 4 km, as compared to the Mavic Mini's Wi-Fi system. It also has less interference from areas with heavy Wi-Fi signals. Improved wind resistance, about 24 miles per hour per second on the Mavic Mini 2 versus 18 miles per hour on the Mavic Mini, for more stable flights. No more worries about taking it out in the windy weather. Improved features for photography, including digital zoom, 2x zoom for 2.7K, 4K and 4x zoom for 1080p, panorama, raw format, and auto exposure bracketing. Faster speed with the new improved motors for those who want to use it for filming sporting events. The above improvements alone have made paying $100 extra for the Mavic Mini 2 Fly More Combo over the Mavic Mini worth every pennies. Here are some of the other features worth mentioning. The Mavic Mini 2's controller is similar to the one used in Mavic Air 2. It has better ergonomic for the hands and eyes. Phone is mounted on top of the controller instead of the bottom. The charging unit can also be used as a battery pack with a standard USB port for charging other devices. This battery charger can only charge one battery at a time. I would recommend to use the charger from the DJI package, as it does charge faster as compared to other standard USB power adapters. Although DJI stated that the Mavic Mini's batteries are not compatible to the Mavic Mini 2's. The Mavic Mini's batteries do work on the Mavic Mini 2, so use them at your discretion. The Mavic Mini 2 uses the same DJI Fly app, so there are no worries about compatibility with the existing phones for those who are already using the Mavic Mini. Note, existing Mavic Mini users need to install the latest DJI Fly app by using the QR code provided. The carrying case is similar to those camera bags with a shoulder strap. It is like carrying a flying camera in a small bag. It also allows us to carry extra items as compared to the molded carrying case in the Mavic Mini. However, it might not provide the same kind of protection as compared to a molded carrying case. Some caveats: the Mavic Mini 2 Fly More package does not come with prop guards, which the Mavic Mini Fly More Combo provides. However, the good news is that the prop guards for the Mavic Mini are compatible with the Mavic Mini 2. The prop's orange markings do not identify the prop's spin direction, which requires extra care when replacing the props. If you are still thinking about getting a cheaper 4K drones from other brands, I would suggest to invest a bit more to get the Mavic Mini 2 for much better features, reliability, and fun. Significant upgrades across the board when compared to the Mini 1. The main one is definitely OcuSync 2.0, which is a tremendous improvement from the Wi-Fi system utilized in the Mini 1. Everything else was bumped up a bit as well: 4K camera, improved top speed, implementation of raw image format. It's basically what the Mini 1 should have been. Purchased after owning the Mavic Mini, first generation, for a couple months. With the first generation, I always had issues with the range. With the OcuSync 2.0, you really get good signal quality without breakup. Click link in description for more reviews.